I need to change.
Got it.
I need to change.
ये करनाल पेश है, यहाँ पे लौंडेबाजी भी होती है, लड़कीबाजी भी होती है, सब होते हैं।
Who do they belong to? They don't belong at home. They don't belong to the government. Who are they belonging to? They belong to the streets. So can you make your streets safe for them? You can't. You haven't.
आप हमें कुछ भी मत दो, नशा दे दो बस.
नशा मुक्ति में 5-5 महीने के लिए दे दे, 10-10 महीने के लिए, फिर वहाँ पे छोड़ देते हैं. फायदा नहीं होता, नशा छूटता नहीं हमारा.
दूर से कोई ये क्या नाम है, कोई अंग्रेज भी आता ना, दूर से कोई फोटो खींच लिया, सीधा पकड़ लेते, उससे पैसे मांग लेते.
ऐसा होता है, हम लोगों को ये नशा चाहिए होता है. अगर अब सुबह दिन चढ़ गया, अब सुबह नशा नहीं करेंगे, हमारे हाथ पैर, मतलब एक आदमी जैसे मरा होता है ना, बासियां लेंगे, आंखों में पानी आएगा, चल फिर नहीं सकेंगे. ये चीजें जो है वो भटकेंगी. भाई चोरी भी कर देते हैं, ठीक है, मेहनत भी कर लेते हैं, कैसे ना कैसे ये नशा तो करना ही करना है, जरूरत है. क्योंकि ये नशा नहीं करेंगे ना तो समझो मरे पड़े हैं हम. आप हमें कुछ भी मत दो, नशा दे दो बस. अभी आप कह दो कि ये बंदा जा रहा है, इस बंदे को ब्लेड मार दे, ले पकड़ा 1000 रुपये, और मैंने नशा नहीं कर रखा तो मैं उसको ब्लेड मार दूंगा. अगर जिसे 3 दिन नशा कर लिया ना, वो बंदा गया.
group is called Paddy's Theatre. The issues we look at are very, very focused on children, especially the girl child, women, and whatever's been happening with society. What is happening to these kids while they are in the remand homes, which are run by NGOs or government shelters? आप एक 12 साल के 13 साल के लड़के को आप शेल्टर में रख रहे हो, उसको वो जेल लग रहा है, you know? वहाँ पे आप उसको sexually exploit कर रहे हो, emotionally, physically exploit कर रहे हो, you know? And obviously that child will learn that language. You know, the child doesn't know how else to behave. They're really extremely, extremely violent. The bada kids will beat up the small kids and they'll beat them up blue-black, you know. There's a lot of violence inherent in their behavior. So 18 saal ka ladka ya 19 saal ka ladka, agar aapko supervise kar raha hai aapke remand home mein, wo person jisko 2,000-3,000 rupees per mahina mil raha hai, is also frustrated. His way of handling the kids is to beat the kid up. The kid is in turn beating the younger kid up. They go back home, the parent is beating the kid up. The kid is beating up, you know. So it's a language of violence that's very, very, very prevalent in our society. And it's really, really, I mean, you see it when you work with these kids.
हम ऐसे समाज में बड़े हुए हैं जहां पर मूल जो मान्यता दी गई है वो असमानता की है। जब भी सड़क पे आते हैं आपको एक नजारा मिलता है, छोटी छोटी लड़कियां, उनकी माताएं या जो उनके साथ हैं सड़क पर अपने जीवन के लिए संघर्ष कर रहे हैं। तो समझने की बात यह है कि ये इतना गंभीर सामाजिक अन्याय जो हम रोज कर रहे हैं, कहां कर रहे हैं उसके उदाहरण हैं।
Them are heavily into drugs, they're heavily into sex trafficking, not trafficking, prostitution. And they prostitute themselves and their bodies to make money because there is no avenue for them to make money afterwards. So they will have small chai shops and things like that. They will sell maal, ganja, whatever, and they will also at the same time sell themselves.
अरे तुम ऐसे कर दे, पकड़, ये कर, वो कर, ये कर, वो सब करेंगे, क्यों? नशा।
My theatre facilitator, the main one, was at the Sabdarjung red light one night, parked at a, was, he was stopping at the red light, and he sees a man, a girl who's 7 years old, is standing next to a car, and this man has a 100 rupee note in one hand, and his second hand under her skirt, you know. And then when my friend went and intervened and said, what is this nonsense happening, that guy drove off, and this girl looked at him saying, I was just making money, you know. So then what do you do? Then that's where the complexity of working with these kids also comes in.
Inka raat ko child sex abuse hota hai, inke saath jo aurte hain unka sex abuse hota hai inko.
Ye samne wala bathroom dekh rahe ho aap, ये बंद पड़ा हुआ है, जो ये इसी काम की वजह से बंद हुआ है। जैसे ही शाम के 7 बजते थे यहाँ पे ये काम चालू हो जाता था।
The exploitation is happening from the middle class. The need to help them is also coming from the middle class. But who is the most vulnerable in all of this? It's the child who needs that money and who's okay with selling her or his body on the streets for that.
Thank you. children on the streets because of lack of proper nutrition. They don't know any idea whether they should take so much of protein, fat, or carbohydrate, vitamins, but also the total number of calories they are taking less. So they have total calorie malnutrition, total protein malnutrition, and most of them are deficient in vitamins. जो खाना उनका है जैसे proper cooking घर में clean utensil में cook करते हैं या clean बर्तन में डाल के खाते हैं तो ऐसे नहीं कर पाते हैं रास्ते में कहीं बैठ गए कोई कागज के ऊपर कोई पॉलिथिन के ऊपर रख के खाना बना खाने लगे उससे भी यही सारे इन्फेक्शन होता है जो कि वाटर बर्न होता है
Who do they belong to? They don't belong at home. They don't belong to the government. Who are they belonging to? They belong to the streets. So can you make your streets safe for them? You can't. You haven't. That's why you see so many kids who are there and then kids vanish.
अंदर से यू सोचते हैं कि मेरा अपना कोई own, my own person कोई ऐसा नहीं है. So many factors are there. इसलिए इनको different personality develop होता है.
तो ये जो तो इनकी जो मानसिक स्थिति है वो नॉर्मल से कंपेयर मत करिए क्योंकि नॉर्मल वो होगा जिसका ग्रोथ नॉर्मल हो रहा सबसे पहला ये है कि क्या माँ का प्यार मिला
जब मेरी माँ ने बोला ना तुम मेरा बेटा नहीं मेरे दिल पे इतना चोट हुआ मेरा दर्द हुआ मैं जब भी सोचता हूँ ये मन करके रोते रहता हूँ मैं सोचा मेरी माँ ने मुझे ऐसे बोल दे मेरा बेटा नहीं तो
सब कुछ होता है लेकिन किसको बताएं किसके लिए मतलब आदमी सुधरू मैं सुधर जाऊं किसके लिए मेरा कौन है कई बार दिल में आता है जाएं रेल के नीचे अपना सर दे दें हमारे दिल की हम जानते हैं लेकिन दुनिया को नहीं बता सकते ना क्या हम किसी का दिल नहीं करता कि मैं रोड पे सोऊं रोड पे रहूं ऐसे कुत्तों की तरह जिंदगी बिताऊं अपनी सब जाते हैं अच्छा बन के रहूं मैं भी मेरे साथ भी मेरे अच्छे दोस्त हों कौन दोस्त है
A lot of people very earnestly With a lot of good intention, ask what can we do. You know, we are not working with NGOs, we are not working with the government, but we still want to help. And these are good intentions, you know. And we say, fine, you start at the red light that's right next to your house. It's a middle class collective responsibility that you have to take. Pick up the kid or see the kid you see every day at your red light while coming back home from your fancy dinner or party. Just one kid, two kids, you see every single day. Ask them their name. Rather than flashing your cell phones to them. Ask them their name, ask them kya padte hain, kya karte hain. Can you take out 1 hour of the day and actually sit with them and teach them ABCD if nothing else? Can you make sure that kid is there every single time you go and when the kid is vanished, actually do an inquiry of what happened to that kid? Can you bother to get out of your car and go to the traffic guy who's there and say, ye bachcha tha, yahan pe 3-4 din se dikh raha tha, ab nahi dikh raha hai. Kya hua? You know, kahan se aaya, kahan se gaya hai? Can you take some kind of responsibility of just having a surveillance at some level and just seeing what's happening with these kids, you know. Where are they vanishing if they're vanishing? Have they vanished and they vanished and gone where? Can you do this much? You know, I mean, it's something as basic as that. I don't know about larger solutions to these problems, but the most basic thing to do is to not remove them out of your conscience. They exist all around you. They're knocking every day at your window pane, you know, when you're sitting in that car. They're trying to get that extra money when they're wiping those, you know, the windshields of your car. They're there begging in front of you every single day. Do not ignore them because that's not going to be the answer to anything.
Hello, gentlemen. आज मैं कहानी सुना रहा हूँ अपनी फुटपाथ की. मैं बहुत साल पुराना बात बता रहा हूँ. 15 साल मैंने इसमें पिए और 2.5 साल मैंने एक जैसन का नशा करा हूँ. फिर उसके बाद दोस्तों के यारों में फंस गया हूँ मैं बहुत बुरी तरह से. अभी तक 25 साल की उम्र हो गई और 15 सालों में नशा करते करते मुझे मैं दोस्तों मेरी परेशानी बहुत हुई है भाई. Thank you.
After having said all this and seen all this, I realized one thing. I need to change.